Okay, fine. So let me start today with a basic concept called exploring Oracle BI repository. So exploring, when I say exploring Oracle BI repository, here we will see different components present in our repository and how to open repository. And what are the modes of opening repository? And what exactly is a repository? What is repository? Okay, so we will see all these basic steps today. So when I say what is repository, repository you can say it as a placeholder for all your metadata. Like when you can import the table definition, the columns and their meanings, and you can configure the joins between them, you can create subject areas and everything. So by using this repository file like RPD, what your BI server does, this builds queries in the backend, sends them to the database and gets the desired results based on your configuration made in the repository. Always your configuration should be taken care properly while developing. Otherwise what happens, if the query generated by your BI server, so BI server blindly what it does, by using the joins that you have given, it will generate a query. Okay, so if you are trying to pull columns from two or more tables where you joined with primary key foreign key relationship, obviously based on your join definition only, Oracle BI server will generate a query. If your join criteria is not proper, or if it is not like the way you are not giving it in a proper way, obviously the results that you are seeing in your reports will differ. So for that reason, you should make sure that all your repository things are proper. Okay, and here we have something called create a new repository if you want to create a brand new repository from the beginning. Okay, and what should we do to open your repository? In Oracle Business Intelligence, you have something called BI administration tool. So you have to click on BI administration. This opens a window for you like this. This has few options like new, or you can see file new repository, or open in three modes. One is offline, one is MDS XML, one is online mode. We will not use MDS XML. What this says is, if your RPD is been saved in form of XMLs, then you can open this XML and make some changes. But we never use this option most of the times. We only use two options, either offline or online mode. When I say offline, you are not making any saves, or you are not checking in any changes to your server. Okay, you are opening an offline copy in your local, making all the changes and saving it in local only. When you want to save it to server, what you have to do, you have to open Enterprise Manager and you should deploy this RPD so that all the changes will be picked up by the server. And in online mode, when I say open RPD in online mode, what I am saying, I am directly opening it in server memory itself. When I say server memory, you can just directly make the changes, check in the changes, and you need not to restart any of the OPMN services. Okay, but with offline mode, what you have to do, you have to deploy the RPD, start all the OPMN components. Then only your repository will be picked up. Okay, just to look.
No deployment or repository is needed, right?
Yeah. In online mode, no deployment is required. So if you are trying to open something in online mode, that means the repository is already deployed and the repository is with server. Okay, so that repository, you are just opening it, making the new changes, checking in the changes back to server memory. And what you are doing, so what is like checkout and check-in? So when I go to a particular hotel, I block a particular room, suppose say room number 101. I am blocking it. Check out. So the room is already available with the lodge, right? So it's already available. We are not building a new lodge or new house or something like that. Okay. Once I say that lodge is already there, so your repository is already there with the management. Okay. Then what I'm just using it. Okay. I am checking out. So when I say check out, no one else can make any changes on that repository. Okay. When I check in all the changes, that means when I am leaving the room, someone else can use it. Okay. Or someone else can change it. Okay, and that room is available for giving you the service. The same way, the repository is available for you in the online mode. If you want to make some changes, check that out, make some changes, just check in the changes, and there is an option called reload server metadata in the front end, in the UI. Just click on that option, it picks up all the changes immediately without starting your component. So we will see that. Online mode and offline mode, how to make changes and all, we will see that. It's not an issue. Just keep in mind, in offline mode,
One.
yeah.
So we only need to check out that particular component only which we are working on, right? Not the whole thing.
Huh, correct. So what
Like
happens? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Informatica, what is like we just check out particular one mapping or workflow, whatever we need to modify,
Correct,
then we
correct,
again
correct. Yeah,
checking
I
that.
know that. Yeah, you do check out and versioning, right? Check out and check in. Yeah. So the same thing what we can do here. So here, see, but what happens with this part is, suppose say if you are checking out whole business model, and you are only changing one table, even it will not allow you to make the changes on the other tables also. It says the business model is being checked out by a different developer. So what you can do is to overcome this, there is something called multi-user development, okay, MUD concept. But we will not discuss about MUD here. But MUD concept, what it will tell you will instead of accessing the whole repository, you will be given only part of repository. Like you will be divide the repository will be divided into different projects. Like in subject area, suppose say three tables I am giving it to developer A, three more tables to developer B. Like this, I can divide and I can give it, and I can check out only those objects and make the changes. But MUD concept and all, we need not to worry, because what happens is most of the implementations where your Oracle BI has most of very very few. If it is very if a team of 20 or 30 are sitting, then only they go for MUD. Otherwise, if it is a team of two or three, only one will be making repository changes, that too directly in online mode, and others can use it. And if other person have it, we can wait until the previous developer checks in all his changes, like that. Okay. But still, yes, we can only check out few objects and make changes. That is concept of MUD. Okay. But we will not discuss about MUD and all here, because that is we should have a shared repository and all, we should do it there. Okay. So yes, for your question, yes, we can still do like that. But as of now, in online mode, if you check out a particular object, no other developer can go and make changes to that business model or subject area, and all the objects will be logged down. Okay.
Rob, in real time scenarios, like you work on production environments, do
Yeah.
you go for this MUD?
No. Till date, I didn't even work with MUD implementations. We had a team of four. Then also MUD we didn't use. I think even you guys will not be working, if I am correct. Because and with BI apps implementations, I think hardly three or four people max will be sitting on a OBIE team, and I think they are more than enough for implementing it. So MUD and all, you generally don't go for it. So very rare. Just people in interview, they will ask, so do you know about MUD? Yes, we know about MUD. MUD concept is like dividing your subject area into projects, and keeping your repository in a shared drive, and giving the access to that shared drive to all the developers. Okay. And only three or four tables can be changed at a time by each developer. If he tries to access any other table, he will not be able to make any change. Only those objects which he is given access can be changed, like that. Okay. So fine, we don't worry about MUD. So just think about offline and online mode. Let me, if you want to open in online mode, all the services should be up and running. Okay, your Oracle BI server should be up and running. And if you want me to open in offline mode, none of the service needs to be up and running. And I can open any of the RPD. Okay, let me open the previous RPDs that we have developed. You have to supply a repository password. Okay. And how to give password for your repository? For the first time when you create a new repository, right? This will ask you for repository password. You can enter your repository password here. Otherwise, after you creating a repository, if you want to change the repository password, you have something called change password. So you can give old password and you can give new password and click OK. Your repository can be opened with a new password. So this is like additional security for your repository. Okay. So here you see something called ABC usage tracking and ORCL. So these are called data sources. Okay. From ORCL is my data source. And when I expand this, I have something called a connection pool. So your connection pool tells your Oracle BI server how to connect to a database, with which username and password, and how to connect to a particular database server. So this data source name will be like, I am giving it as a default Oracle call interface 10g11g, because I have Oracle installed in the local machine itself, and with native call interface itself, this can communicate with your database and gets the results. Otherwise, if it is present on a different server, what you do, you go for your ODBC connectivity, create a DSN, and connect to that server using this. And you can give data source name from your TNS entries. Your TNS name entries will have, right, ORCL equal to your host name, your port, your connect data, everything like this. So from there only I am taking the full DSN description, because with just ORCL it was having some issue, so we took the full description. And logon, I am logging in with the username and password, so by default I am entering it. So whenever a query comes to this connection pool, whenever a query is built on the tables using this connection pool, and if you want to communicate to database, this will be logged in with supplier to schema only, like supplier to login and password. Okay. And you have your connection scripts, write back functionality, and if you want to look into data source properties, right, you have something called general, and database type, you can see this is as Oracle 11g. And here you have something called as database properties. Database features. Here you can see multiple features that are supported by your database. So you can see there is something called left outer join. So the default is it's present and value is like it is supported now. Right outer join supported. Yes. Full outer join supported. Yes. So you can see, and there is something called which is not supported. Percentile is not supported. And there is an option, moving aggregate is not supported by your Oracle database. So there are few options which are not supported by your database. Expressions in order by, not, by supported is not supported. Okay, but order by is supported. Just sorting is supported. And you can say null values sort first. Even this is not supported. So there are a lot of parameters which are not supported, and there are some parameters which are supported. And you can make, even if it is supported, if you don't want that to be supported, you can go and uncheck a particular checkbox value. By default, it will be supported, but you are overriding that parameter manually. But in the, you cannot give anything in the default box. You cannot make any changes to your default checkbox. You can only make changes to your value checkbox. Even if I am giving here, it will not work out, because by default, this is not supported here. Okay, like this.
By default, if it is not supported and we are making it as supported by changing the value in value, then it won't work. Other, the vice versa will work, right?
Yeah, yeah, vice versa will work. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is how your DB features and your display folders, means if you have any folder, your tables are stored in form of folders. Suppose say I can give folder one. So if you want to arrange few tables here, like suppose say I want some tables under folder 1, you can just go and keep it here. So all the tables will come under folder 1 and you can maintain it. Okay. So see, as soon as I keep here, so duplicates are created by default. So when I see folder 1, when I just moved from D1 commission to commission bridge, customer 2 and order aggregate 1, all the duplicates have been created in this folder. So if you want to have duplicates, you can have it. Otherwise, if you don't want to maintain it under folders, you need not to keep it under folders. You can have directly a particular user or a schema. So this is called a schema, and this schema, you can just all the tables can be placed under a particular schema again. And what you can do, when you do something called as view data or update row count, so when I say view data and using a connection pool, so this connection pool will have connectivity details. So just select it. So you can see data present in your table from your physical layer itself. Okay. Your physical layer does not contain any data. This contains only metadata, the table definition and the number of the different types of columns present here. Even then, if you want to make sure that the connection values that you gave are proper in your connection pool, then you have to just go with update row count or view data. See, 475 rows are there when I keep my cursor on that table. When I give view data, I can see data also. So that means the connections that I have given are proper. Total 475 rows are there. It is only showing 100 rows now. So if you want to show all the rows, you can even show them.
How did you pull this schema? Like, you made a connection to the database, you showed that.
Yeah, so yeah, we will see. See, there is some option called as file import metadata. So from ODBC or from your default call interface, you can give your data source name, username and password. You will get connected to the database and you can import the tables. If you see here now, you can see it here. So this will give you an options called table keys and foreign keys. So this we will see. This will come in the next class. As of now, we will show only, yeah. So we will show what are all the objects which are present, what is a table, what is an alias, what is physical layer, what is business layer, what is presentation layer. Then we will start with the business scenario and we will import like this. So when I give next, right, so this will give you list of all the available schemas in your data source or database or data warehouse. We call it data warehouse, right? So in our data warehouse, it gives the list of schemas. So from my supplier 2 schema, see, it has OLAPSIS, OW and all the schemas. See, I created, I told you 2 schemas will be created, right? So DevMDS and DevBI platform. Even these schemas are also created in your data warehouse because these are created during my OBIEE installation. Okay, I have given the same data warehouse. So these tables are created here itself. So in supplier 2, I can see different tables, D1 district, D1 language, LOVD, all these. So it gives grace out if a particular table is already been pulled into your subject area. Into your physical layer. Okay. So like this. So there are some more tables which are not pulled. So you can make use of these tables and make your analysis. Okay, like this. We'll see how to pull this and all. Okay, we need not worry. We'll start from entirely brand new repository. And then we will start working with it. Okay. Now, just you can keep in mind, this is a data source, connection pool, a schema, a physical table or a base table. And this is called an alias. So D1 calendar to table is also there. D1 calendar to alias is also there. So why we go for alias is, one thing is to avoid circular joins. One more thing is, you need not to make any changes. Suppose say your D1 calendar 2 is being referred in. See, this is called a subject area or presentation catalog. See, 1, 2 are there. Suppose if I have 10 subject areas or 10 presentation catalogs, and this D1 calendar 2 is being referred in all the 10 subject areas. So I need not to make changes to div all the 10 tables each time. Create an alias. This alias will be used across multiple fact table joins. And just make the changes to your base table definition. We will see the concept of aliases also. But keep in mind, just make the changes to your table definition. Your alias will automatically get reflected. Okay, now I have see YYMMDD. Now I don't have anything called as alias column, right? So just let me make any changes to this calendar too. What I am doing, new object, physical column. So I am changing this definition. So type as, giving it as integer, I am giving it as nullable. Just see it. So alias column is created here in base table. See, I didn't make any changes to my alias table. So already this, obviously this column is automatically created with same properties, integer and nullable. And this is read only. I cannot make any definition changes in my alias. I can only make changes in my base table, which is like your D1 calendar too. And delete here, obviously there also it will get deleted. So see here also it is gone. You cannot see this. Okay, like this. And this is called a physical column. So and how do your column will know that it should pick same data from your data warehouse? So for that reason, what we have to do, this physical column name and your data warehouse column name should match, then only it can pick. So that is the reason I cannot rename anything here. If I rename anything here, what happens? Obviously your definition is gone. It cannot pick data, because using this columns only, these are called your select column names you will give, right? So these are called your physical column names. If you give your data warehouse column names a different name, it will tell column expression not found or invalid column name. Something like that, because that column won't be there in data warehouse. Okay, like this you have aliases. And not only tables, you can have some more definitions. See here, I can have views also here. So in general, my table type is a physical table. If I give stored procedure, I can invoke a stored procedure from database, or else if I give select, I can write a normal select which acts as a view, like select column 1, column 2 from table 1, table 3, so on. I can write a view here, like normal view you write, database view you write, right? So similar way you can write views in your physical layer of your RPD. You can deploy them to your database. That means you can give, they will be permanently present in your database also. You can do that. And what happens once you pick your view? Obviously the select will be fired, and all those columns you will get information from your base table itself. Right? Fine. Now, so these are some physical. Go ahead, Gauru.
Here we saw, like, we pulled the tables from the Oracle database. Right? So we can have source as different database as well. I mean, we can use different database.
Yes. You can have different database.
Or if you want to have an Excel file only as a source.
Then. Yes. You can have only Excel file also. Yes. You can do that.
And we can use Microsoft SQL Server as well, or DB2.
See here, you can have XML, you can have SBase, you can have Oracle, you can have Hyperion database, SAP native SAP database also. So you can have, with ODBC, you can connect to lot of all other databases, right? So ODBC will connect you to Microsoft SQL Developer or anything. So whatever with ODBC you can connect, all those databases will be supported.
Xamarin also.
I don't know about Xamarin. So will ODBC support it? Chandrasekhar, will ODBC create a, you can create a, do you have driver for that in ODBC?
No.
If you can do that, it will support ODBC AD32. Let me check. System DSM. Configure it. Sorry. So you have multiple Oracle protocol, SQL Server, We have Marin Drive, MySQL, so you have something for. So as of now, only these drivers I have. So if you want additional drivers, you can have the drivers, and if you are able to connect to any other database, all those things can be pulled into your physical layer. Yes, you can do that. It's not only Oracle database, any other. Generally, my project now we are using Microsoft SQL Server. Okay. So like that you can pull from
Super.
IBM DB2 or any even SAP database also you can able to pull it. But most of the cases because Oracle gives you with Oracle BI apps, right? So they recommend you to go for their databases only. But few clients have, if they are maintaining it from olden days, like if they are maintaining it SQL servers or all those, they will still, we can still bring them into RPD. It's not an issue. Okay. Yeah. So now, so you have three layers. One is physical layer, one is business model and mapping layer, one is presentation layer. So we said physical layer is like a layer which has metadata about all your data warehouse objects and their joins. So the diagram that is present in your physical layer is a physical diagram. So when I say D1 calendar 2, physical diagram, objects and direct joins, you can see that it is been joined to different fact tables. Fact D1 order 2, fact D1 orders recent table, fact D1 historical. And when you double click on the join definition, you can see that there is a physical join definition which is present. So by using this join definition only, your query is been built. So where D1 calendar 2 YYMD equal to orders recent period key. So this join definition, how do you give it? You give it using your normal join expression. So how do you do this? So when you create an alias, you can right click it. Suppose say two tables if I want to join this table and one more table. So just right click them, physical diagram, selected objects. See here on the top there is something called a new join. So this we will see all this. We have separate labs for all this. Okay. So as of now, just keep in mind physical layer has physical join, business model and mapping layer has a logical join or logical diagram. Or you call it as a business model and mapping diagram, or logical join, you call it as a complex join also. And one important question is, can you have complex join in physical layer? So complex join is generally used in business layer, right? Can you have a complex join in business layer? Yes, you can have it. If you want to use other than equal to operation. So now whatever you give, you will be having only equal to operation here. So see here. Operator by default is equal to. So if you want to have other than equal to operator in your physical layer, you can go for your complex join. Okay. Now let us see. This is called a business model. So what does a business model do? Business model will store all the corresponding tables from your physical layer. See, these are called hierarchies, and I have DIM customer table. When I say this query related objects, you can go for your physical layer, physical table. I want to see from which physical table this is coming. DIM customer. So you can see that it is coming from DIM D1 customer 2. When I say go to, this goes to DIM D1 customer 2. See, from this table, this business model and mapping layer table is being derived. And this is called a business model, and this is called a dimensional hierarchy. This is called a logical table. This is called a logical fact table. Okay, fact and dimension. When I say fact table, obviously just go for business model diagram, selected tables and direct joins. So when I say a particular table, fact commission as a fact table, you can see arrow will be always pointing to a table which has a primary key. Okay, in OBIEE. So here DIM customer has a primary key, DIM sales rep or dimension table. So this is a star schema. You don't have any snowflakes here. So this is what we were discussing about stars. We should have only stars in your business model and mapping layer. Okay, a fact table is joined to your dimension tables with primary key foreign key relationship. And see, in physical layer you saw the join expression, right? Check in the logical layer. You don't have any join expression. This will only say a particular table has a primary key, a table has a foreign key, and how they are joined. But the logical definition for these two tables, here you can go. So fact commission, physical diagram, objects and direct joins. So this is how it is joined. So in here You see this? This is a snowflake schema. So your DIM D1 commission bridge is a snowflake in your in your physical layer. See here. Your fact table also we are taking. See, this is a different concept, bridge table concept. This I will explain you. But just remember, your fact D1 commission is just a single table in your business model and mapping layer here. So how did you handle it? Go to sources, logical table sources. Under general, you might have pulled this commission bridge table. So what you are doing here, you are taking care of your snowflake into a star. You are just pulling fact commission and commission bridge, and you are handling these two tables under single fact table itself. Under single fact even commission, both the physical tables have been pulled like this. So this also we will see how to model and all this. But as of now, keep in mind, this is a business model, dimensional hierarchy, a logical table, logical fact table. This is called a logical table source. What your logical table source is similar to that of your physical table. So you have fact D1 commission, right? So here also you will have fact D1 commission. So this one. And for column mapping, you have only one column as of now. And I call it as a measure. And I told you, some measures are, some facts are semi-additive, some are additive, some are like non-additive. So I told you there is something called aggregation content before, right? So just observe here, there is something called aggregation. As of now, this is called, I just gave here sum, aggregation type as sum. So against any dimension that it is joined, always your commission amount will be summed up. So you can call this fact commission as a fully additive fact as of now. And if you have any other commission any other measure coming in here, you need not to see. This is just for calling. You can have a different aggregation function based on your definition. You can have different types of aggregations like average, count, count distinct, max. So across any other dimensions, it acts like that. And for each dimension, if you want this to be behaved separately, you can give based on dimensions. So for each dimension, as of now, for all others, it just gives sum. So for a particular dimension, if you want to add it, you can add it. So on each dimension, if you want a different functionality, you can even do that. But as of now, I don't want that. So just cancel it. I don't want to give this based on dimensions. So default aggregation rule is sum. So this is how you define aggregation rule for your measure column. So these are called logical columns. These are called physical columns. So in physical layer, you have physical columns. And you can see that here you are just directly giving your physical column meaning. Without whatever is there in data warehouse, same thing you are giving it here. But you renamed here with your business name, with some meaning to it. Okay. So however user can easily understand, or a business user can read it, you are renaming it in that way. Okay. But it is mandatory that, yeah.
Pratap, like I saw, like in physical layer, you pull the columns directly from the physical database. Like, okay, so all these DIM and fact tables are present as such in database only, right? Like
exactly.
DIM underscore D1 and fact underscore.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
No.
This will not present as DIM underscore D1. This will present as D1 calendar 2. Alias name, I renamed it. You can rename your alias name. Anything. You can rename it according to your name. So to make that as a DIM dimension table, I just gave it as DIM underscore D1 calendar 2. In your database, it will present like this, D1 calendar to D1 commission. But whenever it is queried on your alias, what happens, right? Your physical column's name remains the same, and double click on this, see your source table for this. Your source table will remain the same. Here, your alias name can be given anything, but your base table name will always remain the same. Okay? Yeah,
your logic. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So your source table is the table which is present in your data warehouse. This always remains the same, but your alias name will be given differently. So in your query, when it is fired, what happens, right? So your select will be like this. So even if you fire a particular query on DIM and calendar to alias, right, it will write like this. Select star from D1 calendar to and TIM underscore B1 CALEN DAR. So this just gives comments lines like this. So even from this is like from your base table D1 calendar 2, this will all your query will always tell you how which alias it has been accessed like this.
Okay.
Okay, like this your query will come with your OBIE.
Pratap, if I am not giving alias names, I am only taking the base tables, right?
That time it will just give you like this.
No, that I got it. My question is different. Like, and if I am making a change in the physical table, right? So in the OBIE, we have to make a change in all the instances where that physical table would be used, right?
Exactly. Yes.
Okay.
And if you are directly using the base table, go ahead, Gauru.
Alias makes things little easier. Like if we are using 10 alias of the same base table, we need to change only
base table.
Once in the base table only, right?
Yes. So what you can say, you have a master copy, keep changing the master copies, all your relevant copies will automatically get changed. You can say like that. You have a carbon copy paper, right? So when you write on the main paper, all your sub papers will automatically get written with the content that you are writing on the top. So the same thing. So if you have a base table and if you have aliases, all you can just keep changing your base table. So you need not to worry. See, if you are not doing like this, what happens? Somewhere you might have used, many places you might have used this with a different meaning, right? So what happens? You should keep go to the table, base table. You have to go to your subject area, refer that back and just keep changing the table again and again. So instead of doing that, just make a changes to your master copy. All your aliases will automatically pick up the changes. Because in your alias,
and when we, you got it, Bhutanabh, it is quite clear now.
Yeah. In your alias, all your aliases will have your source table. All your aliases source tables will always be your base table name. Okay, like this.
And when we come to the business model layer, the tables which are present in the physical layer would be shown there, and its relationship would also come. Like if we are talking about a fact table, so in our physical layer, in our actual database, that fact table is connected to suppose two or three dimensions.
Yes, such
it would be showed in business model only, right? All those dimensions with the table.
In physical layer also you have to show it. See, in physical layer, when you are importing metadata, right? So when you import metadata, if you want your join conditions to be properly defined, so from your database, if you already, you know, primary key, foreign key constraints in database, right? How you write it, you know that, right? If that primary key, foreign key constraints are already defined on table, you just can write like this, supplier to string next. So tables, keys and foreign keys, if you just select these three, right, what happens, and click on next and select few set of tables, right, even their join conditions also will come off. You need not to again create a physical join here. The join conditions also will come, but if you want to define the join condition, you can pull tables individually and create aliases and select these two tables like dimension table and fact table. Right click them, physical diagram, selected objects, there won't be any join. There is something called new join button here. Click on this, from fact D1 commission, refer your D1 calendar to, you can select your columns and just give the join definition here. Like this.
Okay.
Okay, like this also you can give. And different ways. But see, from while pulling into your business layer, if you pull this table and this table together, your join also will get carried out. But if you pull separately like D1 calendar 2 once and fact D1 commission once, right, your joins will not come. Again, you have to manually define joins in your business model and mapping layer also. Like D1 customer you have to select, D1 commission you have to select, business model diagram, selected tables, and see this is already there, right? So you can just delete this. And there is something called as new join, right? Just select like this. There won't be any join created. Just click OK and close this. So your join criteria is been present from your fact table to dimension table. Okay.
Business model is used to add extra columns or do any calculations if you
exactly.
want to do on
all
the
the calculations, everything you do here only. You cannot do any calculation or anything in your physical layer. If you want to do it, you have to create a view, right? Select some of this one. Yeah, view like this, like that you can create. But your business model and mapping layer is very, very important layer in your RPD. This is the important layer. All your configuration or all your BI server, how it models a logical query and how it goes to your database and gets the data from your tables is from your business model and mapping layer only. Everything can be configured here itself. Okay. Which how the query should go, which tables are joined in primary key, foreign key, which is exactly is a fact. See here in physical layer, can you differentiate which is a fact and which is a dimension? Will your physical layer differentiate? No, it really
no,
can.
Only in alias with the naming convention I can make out.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Only in alias naming convention you can make out. If I am removing this alias naming convention, if I keep this fact table also is like DIM underscore D1 commission, you will still think this has a dimension table only. So in physical layer, you cannot really differentiate which is a fact and which is a dimension. Whereas in business model mapping layer, your business model layer itself will differentiate. See, you see hash symbol here. On the table icon?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so this hash symbol says that this is a fact table. And these are your dimension tables. There is no hash symbol here, right? So any table which is joined with a foreign key relationship, like which is a fact table, will have this hash symbol. That means this is a fact table. Okay? And here you can see there are XYZ axis present. So this is like a dimension hierarchy. So how you were customer total or your sales rep is being defined. So all this you can use it. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. And your presentation layer is just a layer which is displayed in your answer. So when I log into my application, right? So let me log into my application. Rule is like you can have multiple subject areas from one business model. So when I say one business model, supplier sales, I can have n number of subject areas from supplier sales alone, but I cannot have one subject area from multiple business models. Now I have ABC UCS stacking and supplier sales. I cannot pull different tables from this to one business model, one subject area. You know the meaning, right? Because
my question is, what do you mean by subject area? Like pulling the columns, tables from one business model, right?
See, when I say, suppose say, in your BI apps, when I say service request, so all the service request related dimension tables and fact tables, I can pull under service request subject area. When I say orders, I can pull orders related fact tables and dimension tables under orders subject area. So subject area is respect to a particular area of business. When I say sales, with respect to sales. When I say inventory, with respect to inventory. Like that. Okay?
Yeah.
See, the thing is like you can have only one subject area. Bring in all the tables from your business model. You need not to even divide. It will still give you. It will not tell you like, hey, I am service request, divide me. It will not ask you like that. Okay? It is up to you and up to your business to decide what to be put in a particular subject area and how you want it. Okay, so let me open analytics. Analytics URL database APC 01. Okay, so WebLogic welcome one. So see here, new analysis I am clicking. Chrome has some issue maybe. So when I say new analysis, so this will give you select subject area ABC tracking supplier sales hash one. So I said it is in open this in online mode. So the thing whatever I opened is in offline mode. It has only two subject areas and you see three subject areas here. That means there is a different RPD in your online mode. So to open that RPD, to know what RPD is in online mode, just open this administration tool. Using this administration tool, open your online RPD. So how to open your online RPD? Just click here. This will ask you for repository password, which is welcome one, and for WebLogic user also. So whatever you log in, you have to give this that password. So now you see three subject areas here. Right? And the supplier sales hash one is just a duplicate of it. I created just intentionally. So that means your supplier sales using one business model, you can have n number of presentation catalogs. This we call it as a presentation catalog. This we call as a presentation table. This we call as a presentation column. This we call as a presentation hierarchy. Okay. Now, just what happens is this is just for display purpose. Just for display. So whatever is there here, I can see here. So now I see supplier sales, right? Supplier sales one I have. Presentation hierarchy, supplier sales one I don't have. So just observe here. Supplier sales one I click. So just observe here under customer, time, product, fact, sales, employees. So I have both have same tables, okay? So my supplier sales one also should have same number of tables. Customer, time, product, fact, sales, employee. Fact sales employee, sales rep, commission and returns. Sales rep, commission and returns. So like the same thing. Suppose say I open this online mode, right? I can make changes in online mode. Let me delete this fact returns. From presentation layer only I am deleting. I am not deleting it from anywhere. Or else delete this whole subject area. No issue. Just delete it. But don't do in real time. See, I am not starting any services. Just check in the changes. Do you want to check global consistency? Yes, I want to check consistency. Consistency check fixed certain objects. There are no errors or warnings. So this is proper. So check, save the changes. Go to your repository. Just go to your this one. There is something, or go to here, administration tab. There is something called reload files and metadata, right? So just click on this. So there is an option reloading, please wait. Okay, so got reloaded. Now just click new analysis. Now you will not be able to see the third one, like supplier sales hash one is there, right? That you will not be able to see. Okay, just go to home page. New analysis. So ABC usage tracking and supplier sales. Only these two are there. That means in online mode, if you make any changes, you need not to restart any services. Just go, make the changes, check in the changes, reload server metadata, the changes will be picked up like this. So the rule is like from one business model, you can have n number of subject areas, and there cannot be any single subject area from more than one business model. Vice versa is wrong. Okay. So today we just saw what is a physical layer, business model and mapping layer, and presentation layer. So tomorrow we will start with a business scenario. There is a client called ABC client who is like supplying products to different restaurant chains in US. Okay, that is the thing. And we have corresponding tables, some dimension tables, some aggregate tables, some fact tables are already there in the schema. We will start from brand new repository. I don't want to use any existing repository. We'll start from scratch. Like we'll start with brand new. There is something called new repository, right? So we'll start with a new repository, give the name of the repository, and give a particular folder where it want to get stored, give the repository password, and from base it will. So when I create something called for our batch, we will create something as OBIEE morning batch, MOR underscore. So morning batch, I'll
Basically,
just
from as you we would be starting.
which one?
Basically from scratch step when we would be starting to create
Yeah,
a
yeah, yeah.
repository
We
model.
will start from scratch one. Yeah. Repository name also we will give, and we will start with this like this only. Okay. But before starting, I just
Tomorrow
want.
we would be getting practice, I mean lab something kind of
Okay.
so
You
that we
still
can practice.
didn't get your VMs or anything?
No, Pratap, I mean still we want to learn installation also, and on local machine also we want to install it.
Local machine installation, I can help you personally, but this one, you have 8 GB RAMs in your local machines?
Yeah,
I have
8 GB
6 GB
RAM.
RAM. Yeah, how much RAM you have?
I have 6 GB.
Okay, 6 GB I can install it. The problem is your system will become very, very slow when you work with other applications, right? Because 4 GB will be consumed by OBA11G itself. And
No,
it
we
is
will do
like
one thing. We will work on VM, but just for learning purpose, we will install on desktop machines, lab.
okay, again you will
Yeah.
uninstall it off, right?
Yeah.
Sure,
So one day we can have a
for
session
that
of
reason
installation
I can
only. I
help
mean.
you. Yeah, with that I can help you. Yes,
So when we get our VMs, I mean,
VMs and
would
all.
we
Yeah,
need to
see,
buy them?
you have our admin numbers, right? You have Ishwar number and one more guy, Gangadhar. You have Gangadhar number?
I
Yes.
have Ishwar's number only.
Yeah. So you can call to Ishwar, ask him for VM. They will provide you.
Okay.
Yeah, my job.
Okay.
I'll inform them. And if you want one more admin number also, both of I will give his number also. I'll just call him. Wait, just for a moment. I'll call him. I'll give his mobile number. You can call him and he will help you now itself after the session. Okay.
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 And there are some lab exercises as well which you would give us.
Number eight. We have VMs ready, right? Okay. ఇది కాదు వాళ్ళకి వాళ్ళ లోకల్ అయ్యారు మనకు ఆ స్టోరీ ఉన్నాయి కదా. ఓకే, నంబర్
81233 99 38 30.
ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ. So I typed one number in the chat window. So he is Gangadhar. You can ask him for help. See, there are two ways. Like, if you want to directly practice on our servers 172 and all, you can even do that. But it is like little slow, and these guys will give you VM. You can directly copy it into your laptop and practice. That is better option. Even after the sessions, when you want, you can do that. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, so today just have a brief idea, just what is the physical layer, what is the business model and mapping layer, what is the presentation. That is enough. So we will start from 1 2 3 and slowly learn. Don't worry about higher topics, like slowly just
Okay.
basic. Then we'll slowly, even whatever the topics are showed today, everything will be again each and every day you will keep seeing them. You need not to worry. Okay, so we will
Providing us some exercise also to practice,
Yeah, you
right?
guys also
So
should
that.
practice. I will send you this PDF. There is a PDF here. Even I'll be taking from this PDF only. Okay, so from this PDF, even you will be practicing the same thing. Okay,
Did you send that PDF,
I will send it. I will send it. You need not
Pratap?
worry. Once I start it,
Okay.
right, I will send it. You guys don't worry.
Okay, no
So
problem.
this has each and every step, like move this cursor like this, move arrows like this, everything is there. Even if I am not teaching
Yeah.
you also, you can still learn, but I'll clearly teach you because I'll make sure that you understand it properly and you can work with OBAW, no issues. Okay, so slowly every day we will have 1, 2 or 3 exercises. We will complete them and then you can move forward and practice from your end. If you have any doubts, we can discuss. Fine.
Yeah, fine. Sound good.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. See you
But
tomorrow. Yeah, yeah. Tell me Shruti.
one
Tell me
more
Shruti.
question for VM. For VM, is there any kind of PDF, you know, so that we can go online and
No,
do
no. He will
by ourselves?
for VM. For VM, right? For VM, my admin only will take care. He will only provide that and he will tell
Okay.
you the steps. I gave this number in the chat window. You can take and you can ask him for at any point of time. You can call them and ask.
Okay, sure.
Any issues with your VM, you can ask them. You can ask our admins. Okay?
Okay, sure.
Thanks. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you.
Okay? Thank you. Bye. Yeah.
Bye.